Right, so someone who's watching us, who's actually contemplating getting it done, refractive surgery, as we say. Now, how intensive is the surgery part of it?
So see, as doctors, we like to call everything surgery because whenever you do anything to any part of the body, which is other than putting medicines, it is a surgical intervention. But this procedure can actually sometimes be done even without a doctor touching the eye, with only a laser reshaping the cornea, which is the front part of the eye, in order to remove your spectacles, and the laser firing only for a few seconds. So theoretically, it is a laser procedure which lasts a few minutes, but the medical jargon of surgery may sometimes feel a little frightening for patients. Let me just explain that this is the front part of the eye or the cornea. You know what's visible to you. You sometimes even put a contact lens over this cornea. Now the fact that you need to wear glasses or contact lens means that you need to change the power of your eye.
Absolutely.
So you're doing that either by wearing spectacles or by putting a lens over your cornea. What we are doing in a refractive procedure is simply using a laser to reshape your cornea. Now the laser fires within a micron. Now a micron is 1/1000th of a millimeter. So when you look at a scale, that is, you can't even possibly plot that, right? It is
right.
So fine.
Right.
So that laser is making such fine cuts in your cornea in order to reshape it. And when we reshape the cornea, so it's like having an invisible spectacle or a contact lens embedded in your cornea. So that reshaping the cornea gives you the permanent vision correction. And because earlier, say about 30, 40 years ago, the urge for doctors and patients to get rid of spectacles was always there. So the surgery started using a diamond knife, which was held by a hand. And the doctor used to make cuts to reshape the cornea. Now, obviously, because it's a knife and held by a hand, the results were a little unpredictable. But that was nearly 40 years ago. Things have evolved rapidly. The laser has a lot of software-guided artificial intelligence, so as to say that it is able to demonstrate perfect results, because now we have normograms and lasers that precisely fire in order to carve out a lenticule or basically reshape the cornea in a manner that the spectacle or the contact lens that you have to be dependent on gets embedded or imprinted within the cornea itself.
Right. So someone who's watching this and is getting more attracted to the idea of actually taking the plunge, how much of a downtime should I keep to walk into a center for sight, get myself checked up and walk out with this permanent correction?
So we basically require only a couple of minutes to do the procedure, but what is more important is to have a complete checkup of the eye to see if your eye is healthy enough to take on the procedure. So there are some eligibility criteria. First, you can actually tick them off mentally. You must be above the age of 18. Your power should be stable for at least 6 months, because if your power is changing rapidly, that is not the time where you go for a permanent correction. You should first have a stable power, which normally does happen between the age of 18 to 20. In pregnancy and lactation, this procedure is not advisable. So if you're an adult with a stable refractive power, you should seek out a doctor's appointment. What a doctor will do is simply map the shape of your cornea. And in 95% cases, the cornea, in terms of shape, structure, and thickness, has the strength to take on this procedure. It is a very few percentage of patients who may have an underlying disease called keratoconus who need to be excluded from this procedure.
Sure.
So we do a lot of tests which are fast enough, but because of these advanced machines, we actually create a 3D reconstruction of the cornea, both in terms of shape, thickness, and now with newer devices, even the strength of the cornea. So this, like I said, the outer coating of the eye is the cornea. And because we work on the cornea, if the tests show that your cornea is strong enough to take on the procedure, you are eligible for the procedure. Once the test is done, we gather some measurements, which are then fed into the laser. And the laser procedure, so the time that you spend in the OT is a couple of minutes. You are at most walking in, walking out, 15 minutes. to 30 minutes, depending on how nervous the patient sometimes is.
Right.
But the laser itself is in seconds. So the procedure in minutes, the laser in seconds, and the recovery within a couple of days. So if you walk into a doctor's office on Friday, you can get your self-tested and screened, schedule your surgery for Saturday, take a single day's rest, and be back to work on Monday. So it's really a weekend getaway.
Wow. And tell me something, you spoke about, of course, the other eligibility criteria, but if I'm someone who's got very high power, can this actually help fix my vision?
So the cornea that we work on has certain limits to it because you can't alter a natural structure infinitely. So in case you have a power up to -8 and sometimes up to -10, the cornea, because it is the outermost part, is easily accessible. We work on reshaping that. But if you have a higher power, say above -10, or a high plus power, then instead of working on the cornea, there is a natural lens inside the eye and there is an artificial lens that is available by the name of a phakic IOL. We simply implant that through a 2mm incision. So it's like instead of wearing contact lenses over your eye, you have a lens implanted inside the eye. And that procedure again is only a couple of minutes. So we have solutions up to -30 also. But depending on the range of correction that you need, if it's up to -8, -10, you can go for laser-based cornea procedures like LASIK, Contura, Smile, or Silk. But for higher powers, possibility of correction with a phakic IOL, sometimes known as ICL or IPCL, is there with near perfect results.
Follow Planet LASIK and post your queries to get answers from the experts.